I started playing guitar when I was 12, and I wanted to play guitar because I just wanted to be able to, like, emulate all of the bands that I loved. Blink-182, Green Day, NoFX. I was, like, super into pop punk. And so to me, I feel like guitar playing is still just sort of this, like, kid-like teenage thing. And honestly, I have not evolved that much as a guitar player since I was 12 years old. So it just feels like a connection to, like, my younger teenage self. My dad's a musician, so I grew up around music. Really, truly, from the inception of, like, my earliest memories, they all revolve around music. They revolve around going to see my dad play shows. They revolve around my dad, like, playing drums and practicing in the garage at my house growing up. And there were guitars everywhere around the house. I just, like, wanted to know how to play this thing that had been in my life since I was a kid. The idea of being able to pick up a guitar, sing, and, like, play it, and then sort of be like, oh, wait, I could also, like, write a song using this. And I was, like, classically trained as a singer. Like, I took opera lessons as a kid. So I also really enjoyed the juxtaposition of, like, having this very pretty voice, but then also being able to, like, play this guitar. And it was always electric. Like, I didn't care about acoustic guitar. I didn't want an acoustic guitar. I wanted to be, like, a plugged-in power chord, like, badass. And so I think that that kind of just, like, once I received one and I had the ability to, like, learn, it was just, like, from there on, it was, like, all I wanted to do was just, like, you know, mess around on the guitar and write songs. I didn't, like, start writing my own songs until probably around 15, because, like I said, when I learned to play the guitar, it was literally just, like, my guitar teacher was like, what do you want to play? And I was like, I want to learn Black Sabbath, I want to learn Green Day, I want to learn NoFX, I want to learn Blink-182. Anything that was on Epitaph or Fat Records at the time, like, I was like, this is what I want. And to this day, I still only know how to play power chords, which is really funny because I'm 12 years into my career as a professional musician, and I've written, like, 4 records and so many songs, and I've only ever been able to do them, like, using power chords. In the beginning, like, I just wanted to learn how to play those songs. I think I borrowed from the style a lot. Like, I just sort of learned, like, the way in which pop punk songs were kind of formulated. And then when I turned 15, I started listening to, like, more kind of singer-songwriter stuff. Like, I got really into Joni Mitchell. And I knew that I couldn't play the guitar like Joni Mitchell, and I didn't want to be able to. I was just kind of like, okay, let's see what I can do here. And that's when I started writing kind of more, like, singer-songwriter-y types of songs, but in my own style, using the power chords. And, like, I mean, every Best Coast song is written with, like, 4 power chords, and that's pretty much it. So it's served me well. Very visual memory that I have of Ernie Ball comes from my dad. He played the slinky strings that came in the green package, and I used to see them, like, all over the house as a kid. To me, when I think of guitar strings, I only think of Ernie Ball, like, genuinely, because that was, like, what I was raised around. And when I got my first guitar, like, my dad strung it for me, put the Ernie Ball strings on it. I don't remember a life without music. I genuinely don't remember a life without Ernie Ball strings. And that's not even me, like, saying that because I'm doing this. Like, it's just genuinely that is my number one memory of strings. I am a creature of habit. Like, I mean, look at me. It's like I'm writing songs using the same chords I learned when I was 12 years old. You know, like, I think if something works, if I like the way that something feels, it's like, it sounds good, it feels good, why change it? The most moment that I think I realized Best Coast was a thing and like a career and a job was when I didn't have to have a job. Like, it was just like, oh, this is my job. Like, I'm paying my rent and my bills like from this. And I didn't go into Best Coast being like, this is going to be my career. This is going to be my job. I'm going to buy a house one day. Like, I didn't think any of that. I was just like, okay, I'm going to make music. Bob was my friend. He knew how to play all these instruments. He knew how to record. I hit him up. We did the thing. The early 2010s in my life are just like a blur. I literally went from being a soap store employee at Lush Cosmetics, a college dropout, to starting a band. And then like within a year, I was like playing on David Letterman and like getting recognized on the street, and like my cat was famous. It just happened so fast. And I think because I was so young and I was wrapped up in all sorts of other stuff, like I didn't really ever have the opportunity to like sit down and be like, what just happened? I am my own worst critic, as we all are. I have a tendency to compare myself to a lot of other artists. And so I'll see other artists like, you know, ripping and like writing these really intricate songs. And I'm like, oh, why can't I do that? I don't really have that passion that's like brewing in me. That's like, go pick up the guitar and learn how to play, you know, like, insert name of shredder. Like, I just don't really have that. And I think that that's okay with me. I think that part of why I like to announce it is because it does that thing to me where I'm like, I want to like be the first person in the room to just be like, I'm not that good, so that nobody else can judge me. It's like, I want to judge myself first. Regardless of how critical I am of myself for it, it's like, yeah, I do think that there are probably people out there that look to me as a guitar player or look to me as a songwriter and think like, oh, I could do that. And I have met many people, especially women, out on the road and at shows and stuff that have told me like, you're the reason I started playing the guitar. You're the reason that I wrote my first song. And at the end of the day, it's like, if I inspire anybody to do it, whether or not they surpass me as far as like how good or bad they are at the guitar, like, I don't really care. Like, if I'm the person that inspired them to pick up the guitar and figure it out, then like, that's awesome. When we first started playing shows, like, I played guitar on every single song. Like, I never put the guitar down. And then over the last few years, I've stepped back a little bit and I play guitar on some songs and then I put the guitar down and then I sing and I pick it back up. And it's funny because I feel like the songs in which I'm just singing and then the songs in which I'm playing the guitar, like, they feel completely different. Like, I feel like a different performer. I don't know if it's like, maybe that I'm literally holding a piece of machinery that like when I hit it, it makes a sound, and then I like sing to that sound and like my voice and that note come together and like make a bigger sound, you know? I guess maybe in a way it makes me feel like superhero status. Like, I'm just like, oh, this is sick. Like, I have this thing on me that I'm just like hitting, and like I could like literally throw it if I wanted to and like sort of do whatever with it. It just feels like a certain level of power comes from playing the guitar. When we were making our third record, California Nights, our producer at the time, we were recording something, and I was like, I don't want to play it. Like, I was like, it was just one of my like insecure moments. I was like, I don't want to do it. You do it. And he like went to play it, and like he said this, and like looking back on it, I'm like, maybe I could have taken it to be like offensive, but I don't. Like, I get what he's saying. He was like, oh, I can't play it as sloppy as you. You have to play it. And like when he says sloppy, I don't think he necessarily means like bad. He just means like, that's my sound. Like, that's what it sounds like. And I noticed that like in Best Coast stuff, like if Bob plays my parts, they sound different than when I play them. And I remember like somebody saying to me once in some sort of, I think I was doing like a Guitar World interview or something. And I like, my first thing I said to the guy on the phone was like, I'm not a good guitar player. And he was just like, yeah, but you are like you. And like, you are the player that you are. And there's something to be said about that. And like, nobody else plays the guitar like you. And I was like, huh, like, if you frame it that way, then yeah, it allows me to step back and be like, never mind, like, I'm sick. Like, I do this cool thing that nobody else can do, you know? Something simply is hard, you know? Like, sure, doing something super classic and like flamenco guitar, I'm sure that's really hard. But also like writing a power pop song with four chords and a melody that like sticks with people, it's also pretty hard. So this has been like therapy for me. Like, I'm like, oh, I'm actually like not a bad guitar player. I've like had such a come to Jesus moment at the end of this of like, I have a thing and I do it well and that's good. Right, Snacks?